Right here is the IBM PS2 Model 30 8086 BIOSes. This goes in U17 and this goes in U20. We're gonna go ahead and try it on a Model 25, which I hypothesize will actually work just fine. It'll complain about the real-time clock module because this motherboard doesn't have one, but I have hypothesized that the models of between these two machines are so similar that a Model 30 BIOS will actually work just fine on it. And of course, boot without a reference disk because these are not MCA-based PS2s. They're ISA. They don't use a reference disk or anything like that. So it should just boot up and work just fine. So let's go ahead and plug it in and try to turn it on. And we're going to turn it on with the XT IDE removed because I want to see the boot logo looking for a floppy disk, or it's going to boot into ROM BASIC to show a Model 30 instead of a picture of the Model 25. Let's go ahead and get it apart. Here it is. The Model 35 PROMs are now installed, XT IDE removed. We're going to go ahead and flip it back up and install it. But the motherboard similarities are so strong that U17 and U20 are still labeled the correct numbers that they are from the Model 30, which really shows the inheritance of the Model 25's mainboard coming from a Model 30. And now to power it on. Now, the pins were a little bit corroded. I hope they work. It's due in post. That already right there is a good sign. And I told you, it was going to complain about the RTC. Okay, that's actually really hilarious to see on this. But it proved my point. It works!